All right, so right now I'm driving to O'Reilly's. Well, obviously I'm driving because I'm in the car, and yeah, I'm gonna be looking for that vinyl and fabric paint, and hopefully they have it here. If not, there's an AutoZone, Advance Auto Part, and a Walmart right down the corner. Now we're gonna be looking for that flat black. There's all different types of colors they have, so we're gonna see what we could find. And I'm gonna try and bring you guys more often on these trips. Well, I just got here to O'Reilly's. Let me see if you guys can, there it is, back there. I'm gonna try and include you guys more often on these trips that I make to the stores, or when I'm ordering stuff, or I'm trying to find parts, or when I go to junkyards or anything like that. So, and it gives you guys a better chance to get to know me a little better. It's just the route I want to take for this channel. So, and hopefully you guys are cool with that. So I actually charged my GoPro this time, and I keep forgetting I could use this for like a lot of stuff. I don't have to bring this big ass camera I got with me. So I ended up charging it today. Let me shut up already. Let's go in there and see what we can find. All right, so let me put my camera away. Shit, here. Forgot to turn it off. Throw that down there. Book bag, get my wallet. Let's go see what we can find. So hopefully they have one, hopefully. We found it. Charcoal gray, that's not it. Damn, I don't think they have it. Oh, it's right in front of me. What color is this? Flat black, that's what we want. You. All right. Damn, $8. It's $8. What do you guys think? Two or three? I don't know. I think we're gonna have to do three. I'm not sure. So we're gonna grab all three of these. Let's go cash out. All right, so I got here pretty fast. Let me open this garage door. I think I might paint it outside. I don't know yet. Let me show you guys where I left off here. Well, I pretty much left off where I finished the other video. Some of you guys probably haven't seen that video, so. And if you haven't, go check it out. Pretty much a video on how to gut your car. Pretty much remove all the panels. At least the back end of the car. I didn't do like the front yet, which I'm still not sure what I'm gonna do yet. The cover off the car. Show you guys where I left off. I can't see shit in here, but yep, that's what we got so far. I gotta see how bad that rust over there is. And there was somebody asking me where this dome light goes. Tracing it here, looks like it's part of this also, this front one. So it goes up, down, through there, and then somewhere down there, but I ain't about to go search for that, man. And I wasn't able to remove this shit right here. So I'm just gonna, I don't know what I'm gonna do here yet with this thing here. I kind of think I want to buy another wheel. If you guys haven't seen the wheels I have, it's these right here, RPF1, just basic wheels. I don't know, everyone has these damn wheels, so that's pretty much what I have. I was thinking of buying a spare, like buying one more and putting it in here. There's also a yellow one that's like from the DC5 in Japan or whatever, the Integra over there, and it's like a yellow one. And I think that one clears the big brakes that they have over there, so that'd be a pretty cool one to get, just to place in the trunk. So maybe I'll just get one of those. That'd be pretty cool. But we're gonna need these. We're gonna need this. We're gonna need these right here. Bring these over here. Shit, I just dropped that. About everything we need, we'll place it right there.
All right, so I got everything pretty much set up. I'll show you guys.
Decided to bring my operation over here to this corner. I took the plastic off of these, and I'm gonna just tape the inside of this so none of these connections. Let's see if I can focus in here. none of these connections get messed up or anything like that. So I'm just gonna throw some tape over that and we should be good. I just wanna paint the outside border of this just to get it all nice and black on the edges or whatever. I'm gonna use some wax and grease remover on this, on maybe these plastic parts right here. I'm gonna clean those up real nice, real quick, and then we'll start shaking these cans. If you guys need the number on there, whatever, it's flat block, vinyl and fabric, specialty coating. That's what I got. Flexible finish. I got three of those. So yeah, let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna set up my camera on this tripod. I'll walk you guys. Well, you guys can kind of see what I'm doing. Prepped. I did a wax and grease remover on this, all these edges, this. I taped off this. I'm actually not gonna paint this button switch thing here. I feel like it's gonna come off or it's not gonna hold very well. I don't know, maybe I will do it. I'll see how that turns out, how that looks, but I think I might just leave that like that. I taped off my lights in there. All that other stuff, I don't really care if it gets painted. All I want to paint is this edge right here. All right, there. Now you guys can probably hear me a little better. I flipped the mic over. So, wax and grease remover on that. This is all set. This should be good. I don't think I have to like take anything off of there. All I have is like dirty finger marks on here, so should be good. This right here, make sure that you see how there's this lip right here. Make sure you paint the opposite side of that. So you want this top side right here. This is the side that shows. This side over here doesn't really show. So just have that bottom part facing down like that and just paint this top side. I put some stuff down just so I don't paint the floor. So yeah, I think these I might rotate after I paint them. So this is the side that shows. So I'll start with that side. Wait for it to dry and then flip that over. Yeah, so just put that there. Put that there. Put this here. I might just take these covers off. Paint those separate. So I'll put that there. Boom. Alright. So everything's set up, so we could go ahead and get started on this. Yeah. so this stuff works very, very well. Like, I'm surprised it worked this well. Great finish. It really is for fabric, I think. I don't think Walmart spray paint would have did the same thing. Maybe it would have.
No, this was one can, guys. I'm gonna hit it maybe with a half of another can that I have, and it should be good. I see a couple spots, maybe right here and like right here, but for the most part, this stuff works really, really well. Show you guys from over here. Zoom in. See, it's kind of spotty a little bit. Some spots over there, I hit it pretty well. But yeah, this stuff works well. So definitely go with this vinyl and fabric for this part. I haven't tested it on the plastic yet. We're gonna get to that. I'm gonna finish this up real quick, hit it with another coat, and we'll go from there. So yeah, this is one can, and let's see how it looks after another can. So this thing came out amazing, guys. Check this out. So 1.5 cans is plenty. You finish the whole top. The headliner came out perfect. So I kind of just went in this motion in the beginning, and then I went that way. It's not that shiny black or anything, it's just flat black. It looks amazing. Came out so good. Let me back up a little. That's way better than gluing like a fabric on there or anything like that. Unless you were going that route and we're gonna put like Recaro or something, then yeah, you have to do that. But if you just want that black look, yep, that's what you need right there. This thing worked great. Damn, that shit just came out good. All right, so let's get started on this. Got all these pieces ready. So we're down to half a can and a whole can. So let's get going on this. Thank you. Alright, so this is after one coat. Hit it kind of light. This one was the outer one, the fabric. You can hit that as heavy as you want. Like, it doesn't really matter. But the plastic, you know, just keep it at a distance. And, you know, keep it like, I don't know, I say like something like that kind of far away. Maybe like a foot away is pretty good. The fabric, I'd say stay a little closer to that. So yeah, hit this with one coat. Doesn't look too good yet. I was kind of worried about the visors, but it's actually pretty good. It's not bad. This one I hit a little darker. I didn't want to go too heavy on that, so this one I went a little lighter on. I don't know if you guys can tell the difference. Went kind of lighter on this one. So yeah, I'm gonna give it like 10 minutes and then hit it with another coat. This stuff really does work. Don't cheap out and buy like Walmart paint. I say go with that fabric paint or whatever that thing is. So let's keep on going here. All right, so second coat looks even better, guys. Like, I'm not kidding. Like, the more coats you put on this stuff, like light coats, the better it just looks. So I'm gonna hit it with a third coat on this plastic stuff and it should look amazing. It should come out even better. Let me zoom in on this. It just looks, the more coat, I'm not kidding, like the more coats you put on this stuff, the better it looks, like even the fabric. I do recommend doing no less than two coats on the fabric, three if you can. It just comes out darker, it's just better. It comes out better. I would say three coats on the fabric. And then on the visors, I'm gonna flip these over, do the same thing, two more coats, and I'm good. I know you guys see me without a mask on. It's because I got more than enough. It's windy out. And if you guys can, be as safe as you can, you know, wear a mask, but I'm not wearing one. I'm pretty good here, so I'm not too worried about it. So yeah, this has come out great, guys. So I'm gonna wait another 10 minutes and I'm gonna give it a third coat and I'm gonna flip the visors over, flip this sunroof part over. And oh, I almost forgot, we have to paint the one inside the car. So you know what, we'll go ahead and do that. We'll do, see how much paint I have left. I think we got enough. So three cans is definitely enough. Maybe I'm going overboard on this stuff, but I just want it to come out really good. I don't want to have to do it over. Once it's on the car, I don't want to take it off and do it again. So bring my stuff over here. And we do have to paint. I almost forgot. We do have to paint this up here, guys. So I'm not too worried if this here gets painted. I'm not worried about it at all, actually. No one's gonna see that. So we're gonna go ahead and paint that. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and paint that as best as we can. I might have to slide this like that and get this edge right here. So yeah, let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna actually lay my car cover in here just to protect. Fuck, this shit's kind of wet, but
just to protect my seats and stuff and everything that's in here. Alright, so I put on this mask because it was getting really bad in there. So it came out pretty good.
This is what we got right here. I don't know if you guys can see it because now like it's all black in here, but turned out good, man. Just had to slide that open like that and just get this edge right here. I got some overspray on the glass, but I don't know if you guys can see that, but you could just scratch that off. So, but yeah, that's pretty much done.
All good. Go over here.
And I didn't record it, but I pretty much flipped this over and painted the other side lightly. And the visors are done. They're all good. They're dry. This is all good. It's all good. This visor's all good. Make sure I got in there pretty good. Only thing, I gotta hit these one more time. The small covers for the visors, but other than that, I mean, this turned out really, really good, guys.
So yeah, everything I had to paint inside the interior is pretty much done. So I'm not gonna be installing this yet, guys. We're gonna go ahead and
finish all this inside. Make sure we paint and do all this first before we assemble and put everything back together, because I'm not trying to get overspray on that and just ruin everything I just did. So we're gonna wait on that and just tackle this.
So I know we didn't do much today, but it's just one of them tedious little things you gotta do just to get that nice complete look in the car. Tomorrow or sometime this week, we're gonna go ahead and take the front seats out, take everything out, and I think I'm just gonna respray everything on the inside and just get it all painted, because I don't know what route, I really don't know what route I'm going to be going with. For sure, I'm going to leave the front half of the rug. As far as like the future and stuff, I really don't know what I'm going to be doing. Maybe I'll take the rug out in the future and just have the car like that, you know? I think that's my plan. And we'll go ahead and...
we got to go ahead and remove all the belt buckle stuff. All those. There's four of those we got to remove. All the wiring, we got to just tuck that away and re-loom it. And yeah, there's still a bunch of stuff we got to do. I still don't know what panels I'm going to be putting back on, what I'm going to be leaving off.
We're going to take it a day at a time and just go from there. I haven't decided on what seats I want or what I'm going to be completely doing with the interior. But that's kind of the way it's been with this car completely since I started. I already want to like take out some of the wiring in the engine bay and just like reroute it, because I'm just like super picky. But I'll always include something you guys can use and learn from, or just something you can apply to your cars. Just expect to have that in some of my videos. Either I'm telling you something or I'm showing you how to do something. And let me know what you guys think of the video, man. If you guys like this route, if there's another route you would have took, maybe do fabric like some other people do with the 3M adhesive. And also let me know if there's anything you guys would like to see. Maybe I could include, maybe I can make a video on that. Try and reach me in my comments if you guys can. That's the best way to reach me. So that's it for now, guys. I'll see you guys in a couple days, alright?